maybe in meetings or we also did a small pilot study which I mentioned at the end and narrow down on a particular collaborative task. And the next is the when you build the classifier, then we need to find the accuracy of that prediction model. And finally, we need to evaluate the effect of the feedback depending on the participants' feedback, like the self-reports or any sort of feedback given by the participants. And this is briefly the model, the overall abstract framework, where there will be a sensor data, self-reports, and here you can see like the dashboard, means the feedback can be through the dashboard or can be through a person who will facilitate the process. So what are the expected outcomes? We want to bridge the gap between the theory and the practice of collaborative dimensions. We want to move from a post hoc to real-time reflective feedback. And based on this model, which was in an online collaboration scenario, we want to use the similar model to in co-located collaboration. Like, we want to move from the reflective feedback as mirroring to guiding, which can coach people to during the collaborative events. And this we can discuss later, because this is part of the EC-TEL paper that is accepted this year, where we did the first use case study, as we are running out of time. Thank you. And this one line sums up my journey of my PhD. That is, the greatest danger for most of us is not that our aim is too high and we miss it, but that it's too low and we reach it. Thank you.
Too nice to each other. Thank you. don't emerge in larger groups. And maybe you, because I don't think too much focus is good, so you cannot only say analyze PhD meetings, but being too broad would be also not good. So maybe you can look at the research on the small group research, they even dedicated journals to that, and look what kind of collaboration patterns emerge in these small groups, and then deduct something from that. Yeah, and you had another one.
To intervene in the collaboration process during the discussion, huh?